Alright, this is John Cole with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. And today we're going to harvest some fruit. I'm going to show the guys actually how and when to harvest your loquat fruit. No, this is not a kumquat. Kumquat's more related to the citrus. This is a loquat more related to the apple. And if you are lucky enough to live in California, Northern or Southern California, they will use this loquat tree as an ornamental landscape plant, right? And if you guys see a loquat tree that looks like this, right, all the fruits are always edible, whether it's a landscape tree or whether it's a selected cultivar. They have cultivars like Big Jim, which actually have nice, large fruit. All my loquat trees are basically just from seed. I ate wild seeds. I planted them in the ground. They came up. This tree is actually from a seed from my mother plant in the backyard. They take about 7 years in my yard from seed to be producing fruit. And now this tree is actually just giant and huge. And I want to show you guys actually how and when to harvest the fruit, because, you know, a lot of people may pick them too early, pick them too late, and they're not gonna be right. So anyways, let's head to the backyard and show you guys how and when to harvest the loquat. All right, now I'm gonna show you guys when to harvest the loquats. So if you guys see this branch here, the fruits, if you look, they're kind of like a little bit wrinkly. So on these, I waited a little bit too long. They're still good to harvest right now, but they're a little bit wrinkly. So if you start see them starting to wrinkle, you should have harvested a few days or a week ago, all right? So here's a bunch that's not quite wrinkly yet. Now here's the worst way to harvest the loquats. It's just like, oh, they're ripe. Let's just pull it off. And you pull it off, right? And it separates off the stem. And now it's basically an open sore. If you do this, right, you better eat it that day, because by the next day, that's going to turn brown. By the next day, the brown's going to start to spread and it's going to bruise. The other thing is that these fruits, once ripe, are very prone to bruising, right? Don't just throw this in the harvest box or throw it somewhere, right? If it bruises, it turns brown, and then the brown basically spreads on the whole fruit. The polyphenol oxidase starts oxidizing the fruit. So while you could eat this just like an apple, it's so good. I can't even describe what it tastes like. The skin kind of tastes a little bit like apple skin, actually. But the fruit inside, I'm going to say it tastes like between like a cantaloupe and an apple. I guess that's what comes to my mind instantly. You can't eat the skin at all. You could eat the little bottom, but I generally don't eat by the little bottom. And then when you're done, you guys will see there's a number of seeds inside here. So wow, I lucked out on this one. Look at that. Inside this one fruit, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 seeds. Sometimes there'll be 2, sometimes there'll be 3, but this one actually had 7. All these are viable, and literally these just drop on the ground. And then they'll sprout new trees, and I could dig them up and put them in little pots and then move them where I want them. So that's one way to eat them with the skin. Oh, so that's the way not to harvest. So I want to show you guys a way to harvest them now. Want to use the clippers. You want to come to the bunch, and you want to come right at the stem, kind of like you're harvesting a whole cluster of tomatoes. You want to pull them off like this, and then you want to carefully put this in a box or store them where you're going to store them. If you want them to keep at least like several weeks, you could put them in a fridge like this. But I always try to harvest them like in the whole cluster. That's always the best. Leave the most stem on. But of course, you could cut off each one individually, but leave the little stem attached. Now, a cooler way to eat it, especially if you don't like how the skin tastes, I encourage you guys always to eat the skin. There's a lot of nutrients in the skin, but if you don't want to eat the skin, I'll show you guys this little technique right here. So if you don't want to eat the skin, or you just want the sweetest fruit to have this nice cantaloupe slash apple flavor, you're going to go ahead and pluck off the little top here and then peel it. And you could carefully peel the skin back. I just like peel it all the way to the bottom, to the little like little belly button hole thing at the bottom. So you're just going to go all around and peel it down. I like to do this if the skin is like discolored, because then I don't like to eat it. All right, so you guys can see we got all the skin hanging down on the bottom. Then I just like to hold it, kind of like a corn on the cob, and just eat it. Now, when you eat the fruit without the skin, it takes the fruit to the next level, because now you're just getting the sweetness. You're not getting the kind of tartness. It's not really too tart, but you're not getting the flavor of the skin. It just intensifies the sweetness of this fruit when it's completely ripe. Of course, you don't want to harvest these when they're partially green, and you want them to be nice, full color as well. Loquats, they're delicious. So I've noticed that depending on where the fruit is on the tree, if it tends to be on the outer and get a little bit sun, they'll tend to ripen up a little bit sooner. Oh, these ones, you guys can see hopefully the color difference. These are a lot more orange, so these are a lot more ripe. They're starting to wrinkle. So I'd say this is probably about just about the optimal time to harvest it, maybe a few days before. And if you guys look at the color difference, these still have a little bit of green on the top. And then also they're a little bit more yellow, not orange. So you could still eat these. They're just not going to be as sweet as ripe and ripe. But that being said, these will store a little bit longer. I like to store these in my fridge. It's about 45 to 50 degrees. Not too cold, not too warm. And I'll be able to store these for a few weeks for sure. I'm going to have to experiment more with how to use these. I just like to usually eat them fresh. I'm going to try to experiment with like juicing them and even drying them. You could probably make jams or jelly out of them. I haven't tried that. I don't make jams or jelly myself. You could probably freeze them and use them in ice cream, or probably a cool thing is you could just freeze them and then use them as ice cubes and let them kind of like thaw out in your glass of water, and then you'll have like a loquat flavored water to drink. And then of course, I mean, don't eat the skeets, the seeds. All right, so yeah, you can see I have a whole box here of loquats ready to eat. And I hope you guys enjoy this quick episode today, learning about this amazing ornamental tree. It does not drop its leaves, and that's why it's used in California. It's an evergreen tree, originally from Asia, as a landscape tree. And it fruits, depending on where in California you live, could be like, you know, springtime into the summer. I'm here in Northern California, and I'm harvesting the fruit right now in July. Although if you're more south, it's definitely going to be a fair bit earlier. If you guys enjoyed this episode today, learning about the loquat and when to harvest it in the short format, hey, please be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. More importantly, share this video with other people that live in California so that they can start harvesting their friends, neighbors, and loquats that are planted on random properties as a landscape plant, because yes, the fruit is edible. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on my new upcoming episodes of Command every 5 to 7 days. You're gonna know our show up, or we'll be learning on my YouTube channel. And make sure you click the little bell so you get notified as many videos come out. And finally, be sure to check my past episodes. The past episodes are a wealth of knowledge. Over 1,700 episodes at this time on the channel dedicated to teach you guys all about growing and even eating your own food you grew yourself. So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, keep on growing.